Βρισκόμαστε στο χώρο του πρώην καπνεργοστασίου, ενός ιστορικού κτηρίου, το οποίο χτίστηκε το 1930 και μέχρι τώρα έχει διανύσει μια μεγάλη ιστορία. Σαν καπνεργοστάσιο παραγωγής καπνού στην αρχή, στη συνέχεια πέρασε από διάφορες φάσεις και στον πόλεμο φιλοξένησε πρόσφυγες και έφτασε το 2000 να αποδοθεί στην Βουλή των Ελλήνων.
Ξεκινώντας από το σκοπό της παρουσίασης μιας περιοδικής έκθεσης σύγχρονης τέχνης, είμαστε περήφανοι που συμβάλλουμε στη δημιουργία ενός πλήρως εξοπλισμένου εκθεσιακού χώρου στο κέντρο της πόλης, ανοιχτού, φιλικού και προσβάσιμου σε όλους τους επισκέπτες. Καθοριστικό στοιχείο στην προσπάθειά μας ήταν ο σεβασμός στη διαδρομή του σημαντικού αυτού ιστορικά και αρχιτεκτονικά κτηρίου, αποτύπωμα της εγχώριας βιομηχανικής κληρονομιάς και της ανάπτυξης πρωτεύουσας. Ειδικότερο αντικείμενο εργασίας αποτέλεσε η συνέχιση και ολοκλήρωση της επισκευής των χώρων του κτηρίου με στόχο τη λειτουργική τους επανεκκίνηση. Αναπτύχθηκε συνολικά ο εκθεσιακός εξοπλισμός με εγκατάσταση νέων συστημάτων φωτισμού, τοποθέτηση επίπλων και δημιουργία νέων χώρων καθιστικού για το κοινό. Πραγματοποιήθηκαν τοπικές επισκευές τυχοποιών και πλήρεις βαφές και ολοκλήρωση του βιομηχανικού δαπέδου σε όλους τους χώρους. Πραγματοποιήθηκε η λειτουργική αποκατάσταση των χώρων υγιεινής και δημιουργήθηκε νέος χώρος υγιεινής για αμαία.
Σε αυτό το πλαίσιο συνεργαστήκαμε πάρα πολύ στενά με τους ανθρώπους του νέου, με τη διευθύντριά του, με τους μηχανικούς. Έγιναν εργασίες γύρω στο 1/3 της έκτασης του κτηρίου. Όλος αυτός ο εξοπλισμός και όλη αυτή η υποδομή θα παραμένει στο κτίριο σαν παρακαταθήκη. Μετά το πέρας της έκτασης αυτής, η Βουλή θα έχει τη δυνατότητα να χρησιμοποιήσει αυτούς τους χώρους για ανάλογα πολιτιστικά εκπαιδευτικά δρόμενα. Και θα αποδοθεί βέβαια και στον κόσμο της περιοχής σαν ένα πολιτιστικό κέντρο της Βουλής.
Καλησπέρα σας, κυρίες και κύριοι.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Dear participants, it is with great joy that we welcome you to this historic building of the Hellenic Parliament. The refurbished by the cultural organization NEON, the former public tobacco factory, this innovative space where in a few days, on Friday, June 11, the exhibition portals will receive the public. This new space is inaugurated with the international exhibition on the title Portals that takes place in the framework of the cultural program for the anniversary 2021, and it is the result of the cooperation of the Hellenic Parliament and the cultural organization NEON. 59 artists from 27 countries, some of them are amongst us, and I would like to warmly thank them and welcome them, give their signature and shape in this space an international acclaimed cultural event. In the video that preceded, you saw step by step the phase of refurbishment of some parts of this building. This historic former public tobacco factory is reintroduced as a modern cultural center of high aesthetics and international scope that inspires the visitor, both with regard to the past and the future. In the current conjuncture, where on one hand we celebrate 100 years from the Greek Revolution, and on the other hand, the pandemic creates a new reality with unprecedented concerns and reshufflings, this exhibition implies the transit from one world to another, shows the portal to a new normalcy post the pandemic. The Hellenic Parliament, as a democratic and representative institution par excellence, can also operate as a vector of this new perspective of the Greek society 2 centuries after the creation of the Greek nation, and through this cooperation can demonstrate the potential we have as a country for a new onset. At the same time, portals have a new dimension, tangible one, which is no other than the portal of this historic building complex that connects an era of Greek society with another. As the visitor will see, the exhibition spreads in all the refurbished parts of the building, and the artists have used various means and techniques for their works. Amongst them, we have 15 new commissioned works, especially for this place, this venue. At this point, before presenting our speakers, let me inform you that the press conference is transmitted live from the TV and Web TV 1 of the Hellenic Parliament and through live streaming of the NEON YouTube channel. On the exhibition and the wonderful artifacts hosted here today, we'll listen to the speaker of the Hellenic Parliament, Mr. Constantine Tassoulas, the founder and head of the NEON Cultural Center, Mr. Daskalopoulos, and the director of NEON and curator of this exhibition, Madam Elina Kountouri, the co-curator of the exhibition, Madam Madeleine Greenstein, will address the audience through video since she could not attend, she could not visit Greece from the Chicago Museum where she presides. We give the floor to the Speaker of the House, Mr. Tassoulas. Ladies and gentlemen, I welcome you, we welcome you, and not, I say we welcome you, and it is not a form of gentillesse. We welcome you along with those who express the cultural organization NEON to this press conference for the exhibition of the Hellenic Parliament and the cultural organization NEON entitled Portal. We welcome you with great joy because this preparation of this portal, of the portal that was effected here in the spaces of the former public tobacco factory, which we can now claim that it is also an art factory. This exhibition was prepared and was staged during this very oppressing period of the pandemic. And now that things gradually change, gradually get more loose and are improved, I realize that art is one of the factors that signal here and elsewhere in Greece, in Athens and in Greece, that signal the gradual and careful recovery of our freedom. Art in our country is one of the bastions of the flag bearers that demonstrate the recovery of our freedom. And this is most important. One of the reasons why this adventure that has been lasting for 15 months has brought about a great disruption and has disorganized us is because the pandemic management is not tough or extremely difficult, as many sustain. What is difficult can be easily addressed, and you realize what I say with this oxymoron. Dealing with a pandemic was primarily unnatural for the human capacity, for the human genre. What is coincides with the human capacity, that is sociality, being a sociable creature, this was transformed into a menace. And this menace, this threat, had to be dealt with ways which delete the social character. And this was an unnatural condition for all of us. The results in our country to date are better than one would expect, are far better compared to many countries. But within this situation, within this condition, the preparation of our re-meeting with freedom had also to be effected through art. The Hellenic Parliament has a rare and very unique building real estate asset. And I do not refer solely to the monumental building of the house itself. I also refer to this very robust industrial complex of the beginning of last century, which underwent a lot of changes during its life. The most astounding change of this building is what you currently witness, what is currently hosted here. What is hosted here is the cooperation of the Hellenic Parliament with the innovative foreground cultural organization NEON. And it was a great joy, a great satisfaction that I felt when Mr. Daskalopoulos, who is a renowned businessman and art collector, submitted this proposal for cooperation with the Hellenic Parliament so as for the old tobacco factory to become an art factory, if you allow the expression, and therefore face, along with you and our guests, along with the Athenian and Hellenic public, until December this year, face the need of people for communication, for dialogue, for the change of views through modern art. There are various ways to handle public spaces. One way is for the manager to be also the guardian of those spaces, to keep those public spaces closed, enclosed, unsociable, immovable, to protect them thus against any intervention, any visit, any eventual improvement, any eventual change and refurbishment, but also against any interaction. The other way to deal with public spaces, to public space, is to view it as something that is in need, as it happens with any human being, to come in contact with society, to converse with society. I consider, therefore, that this is the most fertile stance for any public space, from the archaeological sites to the listed spaces, and which partner could be better, which one could be better interlocutor in the liberation of a public space than the cultural organization NEON, which had such an astounding history ever since 2013 of promoting public spaces, taking care of public spaces, and bring them in contact through modern art of all citizens. Therefore, we promptly accepted this invitation in the Hellenic Parliament during this very oppressing but very fertile period of the pandemic. We gladly accepted the proposal of Mr. Daskalopoulos and the head of the organization, Madame Kountouri, to liberate an emblematic public space, the old tobacco factory that has been operating, that operated since 1930, so as to host here modern artworks of both Greek and foreign artists, innovative ones in the foreground, and through this hosting, to give the opportunity to the Athenian public and the Greek public at large, the onset of a fertile dialogue on modern problems. It is not, of course, by chance that this happens at the 200th year anniversary of the Greek Revolution. It coincides with a reset that we try to make, both at the individual and collective level. And this approach through art and through memory in other exhibitions that regard the 1821 revolution, this discourse and these thoughts will make us more mature and ready for the transit to the new era. Therefore, the Hellenic Parliament opened its gates to the exhibition portals, warmly thanking our interlocutors and companions in this transit, Mr. Daskalopoulos, Madame Kountouri, and the distinguished cooperators. And I think that this semester of this of the presentation of so important works of art will be a very positive and fertile announcement for the next steps for the exploitation of this robust building, which is to play a very important role in the cultural events, both of the immediate vicinity, the area where we are, that is the area of the Platon Academy, which is ripe with cultural events and memories, but Athens at large. I would also like to thank my cooperators in the Hellenic Parliament, the technical department, and the services that are hosted in this building, that is the library and the printing house of the Parliament, who, with a very practical approach and great generosity, embraced this innovative cooperation. And the results and the fruit of that cooperation are now presented through you, will be presented through you to the Greek public. Thank you. Warmly thank you, Mr. Speaker. The Hellenic Parliament addresses modern challenges and cooperating with remarkable and innovative agencies such as NEON develops, promotes art and brings it close to the modern Greek citizen. We give the floor to the founder and president of the NEON cultural organization, Mr. Dimitris Daskalopoulos. Good morning to all. The organization NEON evolves within the city, in the city. Its natural space is the city, because its role is precisely to bring modern culture closer to all, make it accessible to every single citizen of this country. where our activity is based. The pandemic has brought a disruption of this natural relation we have with the city and the citizen. I believe, however, that it has not disrupted our mental and emotional wish to reconnect amongst us. And I'm extremely glad that this reconnection takes place also here with you and through you in this space, and I welcome you all. I look forward to the days where people will have the absolute freedom to come and visit such spaces without any kind of health concern or other. I feel that we have gone through the portal to the next day, to the day after, following a great period of uncertainty and concern. But isn't it uncertainty and concern that trigger creation and creativity? NEON has never ceased its program, and this is why we're here today, after so much work that preceded, claiming the day after and drawing our inspiration from our own principles and incentives, which, as I told you, is the wish to bring the citizen, every single citizen, close to modern art. And in an innovative, if you like, way, continuously connecting the city, our monuments, the spaces and venues of the city with art. So over the last 8 years that we are active, we have presented more than 28 exhibitions in 25 different spaces all over Greece, in cooperation with both state and private agencies of Greece and abroad. And in this framework, this wonderful cooperation today, through which this 6,500 square meters of the former public tobacco factory were refurbished, and thus we deliver a new cultural space in the city and also present the exhibition portals currently. This exhibition takes place within an environment of reckoning and rethinking towards a national self-consciousness, but also at the midst of a world concern and rapid changes. This space that we opted for can definitely offer additional weight to this exhibition, because this is a space that goes hand in hand with the history of this country, a history of development, of challenges, of doubting, of political and social turmoils and intensities. I have the deep conviction that modern art makes you go hand in hand actively with one's era, makes you evolve consciously in this rapidly changing world. And for this reason, the exhibition portal is affected within this world of major changes, hosting 59 artists from 27 countries that offer us their stimuli through their work. So I hope that this will be an opportunity for each and every visitor to wander on today, claim tomorrow, each and everyone on one's own way as one feels it. I would like to warmly thank the Hellenic Parliament and especially the Speaker of the House, Mr. Tassoulas, who from the first moment had the great courage and open spirit to embrace this initiative so as to reach today's result, which I believe you will all admire and enjoy, and it will touch many souls. Let me also stress that within and during the pandemic and its difficulties, a wonderful work of cooperation has taken place from the people of NEON with the people of the Hellenic Parliament. Those that have been working here, half of the building is in operation, and all those who had the responsibility to assist to monitor this project. And for NEON, this is not a new experience. This is an experience, an important one, but we have already witnessed before. It is one of the biggest satisfactions from the NEON operation. Let me first say it in a nutshell. This is a cooperation of public and private sector. This is a PPP by excellence, a public-private partnership. It is the cooperation of public liability and private creativity. And even far better, what I've seen happening in our cooperations with the public all those years is that the cooperation of the private liability and creativity with the public liability and creativity. And this is a very useful lesson, because through this cooperation, this kind of partnership, in open spirit, we can really do miracles for our country and the citizens. Thank you. We warmly thank you, Mr. Daskalopoulos. Through this exhibition, modern art becomes accessible to the public who come in contact with internationally renowned artists. Let us now follow the video and address of the director of the modern Chicago Modern Art, Madame Marlon Christine, who is a co-curator.
And its first exhibition, Portals, is the pinnacle of NEON's varied and extraordinary collaborations over the years with cultural bodies in Greece and internationally. A live network of exchanges of which the Museum of Contemporary Art Chicago is a proud partner. Having said that, the Hellenic Parliament and NEON's cooperation in the renovated building of the former tobacco factory marks a watershed moment for public-private democratic enterprise models and serves as a best practice example of private and public interests coming together for a greater common good. Culture has always been a key driver of progress and development, as well as of the growth of personal and collective hearts and minds. NEON, the Hellenic Parliament, and the people they both serve understand the deep importance of art and its capacity to inspire and help evolve our world towards greater peace and justice. It is significant that the ancient Greeks defined art as a form of catharsis, the experience of which functioned as a release from a specific and commonly held trauma. As we emerge from the ordeal of this last year under the COVID pandemic, we turn to the ancient wisdom of the Greeks on the 200th anniversary of their country and present Portals in the tobacco factory as an invitation to reconceive the world anew and move into the future we desire.
As it was mentioned by Madame Kritsin, that we greatly thank, we turn to the ancient Greeks, their wisdom and art, which is a form of catharsis, so as to reset our priorities following the new data created by the pandemic. We give the floor to the director of NEON and curator of the exhibition, Madame Elina Kountouri. Hello. Honorable President, Speaker of the House, dear friends, let me start by expressing our gratitude to the Hellenic Parliament and the Speaker, Mr. Constantinos Tassoulas, for the trust they showed in implementing this program and integrating modern art in the modern framework of reflection for the 200 years of revolution. You spoke of a meeting. It's true that NEON has coexisted with all the persons from the Parliament. I would like to warmly thank them for this cooperation and this hosting, because we are always I would like to thank the cooperators of NEON, because we are here a year that we have gone by. And I would like to declare my deep estimate to the Greeks, the Hellenic artists, and those who worked from abroad through teleworking, Zoom, and the kind of unnatural meetings, because this avowed natural presence. I would like to express my deep gratitude for their insistence, for their concerns, and without them, we would not be able to be here today. We would not be able to be here without the support of the founder of NEON either. And in this framework, through this exhibition, the recently refurbished former public tobacco factory opens its course in modern civilization. The exhibition portal is a project that was affected on three parameters: a study and restoration, refurbishment of historic building, curation and organization of the exhibition, and the operation of the space itself. Our cultural program, in cooperation with the Hellenic Parliament, aims at demonstrating how at this specific point in history we are led through a portal. The journal of the author Arundhati Roy in Financial Times on April 3, 2020, on the portal, the title of that article was "The Pandemic as a Portal," and how we negotiate our transit through it was the inspiration. The crack exists. Nothing could be worse than coming back to normalcy. The pandemic is a portal, a point of transit from one world to another. So once we go through the other side, we will have to reconfirm, for the good of the next generations, our commitment into specific principles: recovery of trust, human rights, democracy. Global scale of challenges and the impact of the pandemic make this reaffirmation more demanding than ever. In this exhibition, the cracks created in the society demonstrate our common experience. The experience is now common, communal, collective, and through time. The political and social impact of pandemic demand the active participation of the citizens. The exhibition raises questions, concerns, and encourages an open field of interaction for the reshaping of society, economy, morality of politics. Artists remind us that it is no more a choice to remain passive spectators of the change. So how can we negotiate our space through and towards a portal, towards the other side? The exhibition negotiates precisely and handles this intermediate space concerning the analysis of those concepts: movement, communal, and connection, and home. Artists from various continents and various cultural subgrounds converge so as to build a communality of ideas. Their works become the witnesses of a possible such new normalcy. We narrate the history of this transit, but we leave it to evolve. We do not present some kind of doctrine, but a narration that promotes and shows the challenges, concerns, and rapid changes affected all over the world. It motivates the visitor to think of the future, selecting whatever moves him, whatever makes him feel fear or hope. We exploited the architecture of the space as an open space for the coexistence of the works through the possibility offered through the visual escapades from all the venues. The works are presented in all the refurbished spaces of the building, the surrounding space, the venues, and the attics, the old customs office, the roof, and the Colonos Hill. Allow me a brief presentation for those who are not present. The work on Nikos Navridis on the facade welcomes the city and the visitors with the phrase of Samuel Beckett: ever failed, no matter, try again, fail better. While in the Brendan Fernandez creates a performance, a solo, Until We Dance Again, a new commission for the specific exhibition. It invites the visitors to address the question, imagine tomorrow without fear. The new commission on Kolonos Hill by Chrysanthi Koumianaki activates the broader area. The internal atrium that you see here is dealt as the public space of the exhibition. The social movements and symbolic gestures coexist, creating common memories. The public space is our memories. The British artist and director Steve McQueen presents the work Portrait as an Escapologist, an installation from paper photos. The version of McQueen reiterates his own picture, intending to imply the barbarism of ship that transferred slaves. The American artist Glenn Ligon presents a new commission made of white neon lights. Waiting for the Barbarians includes 9 different translations of the last verses of Konstantinos Kavafis' poet, Waiting for the Barbarians. The very the meteoric installation of the Cypriot painter Maria Loizidou on the title A Monumental Lightness is a monumental work. At the same time, one feels the finesse and real translucence of the work. Complex histories are also registered in the new commission installation of David Vaux. For David Vaux, everything, architecture, vegetables, sculptures, relics, they are all considered already burdened. Within the internal courtyard of the former tobacco factory, Vaux's installation creates an additional public space. His cedarwood pavilion provides further areas to gather, pause, and consider. The pavilion was constructed by the Dong people in China's Guizhou province and inspired by their folk architecture. Vaux has adjusted this kiosk, having around watercress plants. And this word comes, the scientific word, Tropelum magus, comes from its branches that remind of the trophies of the Roman vanquishers. In contrast, a picture, a wooden picture of the crucifixion that dates back to the 17th century is lying cold and naked on the surface of a Carrara marble. All this was created here by Vaux in the last week and makes insinuations to sculptural depictions of the male form. These combinations of objects speak of care and creed, of care and loyalty, the mourning and loss. Our visual sensitivity is enhanced by the rising sea, by the excellent artist El Anatsui from Ghana. The atrium is a tribute to a world that needs healing and unity. Going and proceeding on the western part of the corridor, we see communal portraits through sounds, words, maps, and tabloid newspapers. As the Indian artist Shilpa Gupta, words come from ears, we see a moving mechanism of announcements. Gupta creates a unique language environment through sound and fragmented words. Do we need a permit to breathe? She asks. Language is a common denominator that goes through the whole exhibition. The work by Felix Gonzalez Torres goes and runs like a frieze under the windows. The work exists through every change. Each lender has to create it through a new way, taking away new events and or including a new word or a new date related with an important event. For the exhibition, the phrase Freedom 2021 has been selected and written in the Greek alphabet. It is the first time that such a word is integrated in the history of this work and will remain there. It is a reference to the 200-year celebration from the Greek Revolution and the birth of a free nation. With the mention of the word freedom, the individual, political, and historic become one. There is a new commission to Michael Rakovich, for which I will speak about, but unfortunately the work could not be here this week. It will arrive at the end of the week. This happens in such a big event under these circumstances. But the work of Michael Rakovich is a new commission exploring the politics, nationalism, and the traumas of the loss of war, and especially through the experience Iraqi-Hebraic legacy. Brakovich describes his work, Carta Baghdadia. They were scanned from the valuable Haggadah of his family. The publication of Haggadah from 1936 accompanied the flee of his family from Iraq to the USA in 1947. The material delicacy and vulnerability of his beloved Haggadah reflects the precarity of the memory of those who live in the diaspora. Although the text is in Hebrew, it includes Arabic characters. The title Carta Baghdadia is reference to the Greek Carta of 1796 of Riga Velenstin Lys. Carta Baghdadia is presented in relation to the six pages of the Carta of Greece that belongs to the collection of the Hellenic Parliament. In contrast, through some sculptures and textiles and hand-woven works, Adriana Verajao, Sonia Gomez, and Solanga Pessoa, three different generations of women from Brazil, transfer the rich history of their area. In an other, in Juarez, we have the presentation is from an area with great criminality. All those create a calendar, a chronicle of the murdering in this city, and it is kind of archaic. There were three rooms, one next to the other, that were refurbished by NEON, and which were used, the ground floor for cutting tobacco and the attics for the manufacturing of cigarettes and cigars. So in room one, which is a depict of how the building used to be, we have the prevalence of the notion of equality in relation to labor, social justice, and resources. The main installation is by the Turkish artist Kutluk Ataman. The work of Adam Pendleton deals with such histories and raises issues of social justice and tribal and race equality. The work of Yannis Kounellis touches upon the ecumenicity of the ideas. He always mentions that his work concerns the human being. The relation of the work with the labor, human labor, resonates the harsh working conditions in the former tobacco factory. The labor policies and engineering are also central in the work of Maria Papadimitriou and Anastasia Sudiku, which was also a new commission. In Attic 1, female voices from all over the world share this floor, along with the works of the American Ed Roussa and the Greek Vangeli Goka. The diary of Elif Kamishli follows the personal course of this Turkish author as a mother, sister, daughter, and professional during the turmoil of 2015-2016 in Turkey. In this part of the exhibition, we celebrate the many lives of powerful women whose course show a very perspicacious understanding of the human condition. Therefore, we see their works of the innovative female artists Marisa Mertz, Alex Milona, Erika Vertsuti, and Dana Schutz, along with younger artists such as Seidel Meneshe Hansen, Tala Madami, Gala Poras Kim, and Myrto Xanthopoulou. Room 2 represents a common agreement, the power of unofficial networks, the development of unofficial networks of relations that were formed methodically or on an impulse in order to attain specific goals, demonstrated that social links is the only way to handle and manage this paradox. The artists have always survived thanks to unofficial networks with solidarity and interdependence through means and ideas. In this room, the works of Louise Lowell, Elias Sime, Yanni Kounellis, Lillian Lean, and Daphne Wright create an unofficial network of power, of personal courage, of urban stories and legends. In Attic 2, we see the work Magna Carta, an embroidery of the British painter Cornelia Parker, that pays tribute to the Magna Carta of 2015. The main body of this text was embroidered by jailed persons, local cooperatives, activists, politicians, judges, lawyers, legislators, and presentators. In Attic 3, we see the house in the architectural installation of the Korean Doho Su. We see a replica of his apartment in New York. The apartment is a house, a refuge, and a storage, a memory storage. We see the links between works of Christiana Sulu, Apostle Georgiou, Robert Gober, Paul Baggy Sepuya, Francis Picabia, Joanna Humali, Billy Zakveba, and Oyan Hoji Odotula. Going up to Attic 3, we see the condition of the attic. The new work of Alexandros Giannis, commissioned by NEON, is related with elements of the internal structure of the former factory. Giannis illuminates regions and margins, turning our attention to the coins and of the rooms, as well as the communities, which are usually not acknowledged. The work of Gianni also converses with the geometric installation of Nikos Alexios, Vlas Kanyaris, and Erika Vertsouti. In the old toilets, we see the work of Ada Minotti Tereteras. The thematic of interjection of Dimitris Antonitsis are the well-known home and cultural forms of vases and amphorae. In the exhibition portal, Adrian Villa Rojas comes back to Greece through his new project, The End of Imagination. Two screens consisting of 16 distinguished LCD TV screens show excerpts of 16,000 video hours in real time from various points of the planet. This, The End of the Imagination, is an ongoing cinematographical venture that was launched at the end of March of 2020. Villa Rojas and his team became visual nomads using material from web cameras which were publicly accessible. The material was collected and monitored and edited by five persons who worked 8 hours per day for 12 months. Villa Rojas wants to show that this unequal access to the internet needs Western Europe to be defined by its buildings and monuments, while the African continent will be defined by its wild nature. The old part of the building is covered by the artistic intervention of Duro Olovo that has parts of sculptures, textile sculptures, paintings, videos, tapestry, wall murals, showing various histories. In December, we will have the activation of the ground floor as well with a performance by Dimitris Papayoannou Sisyphos. In room 5, we explore a probable dystopia. The new commission of the work, Ellinico, the Greek, by Panos Kokinias, narrates a single history by combining many fragmented pictures. The work by Kostas Bassanos, The Eclipse, creates a new body of earth creatures. The series of sculptures, Glow, by Kapuani Kiwanga, introduces us the lantern laws, when in the 19th century the slaves or the black people and the indigenous were obliged by law to carry an open lantern after the sunset. Anna Tsouklarakis took interviews from the Navajo members, and she consulted fellow members in an informal survey about the disruption of harmony. Irini Evstathiou explores the collective memory and identity in juxtaposition of various archive pictures. The three pictures, To Choose Your Flag, take the context when we sing together. The pandemic has brought society and individuals in a period of extended and traumatic, in many cases, self-examination. A fleeing look through the gate to the other side shows opportunities to build something new. We may be nervous, justifiably so, but as Arudanti Roy wrote, we can go through the gate on a very light pace with very few luggage, ready to imagine a new world. This is what we try to do and attain in this public, former public tobacco factory. Thank you, Madam Kountouri. I'm certain that following your detailed presentation, those who follow us who would like to explore the spaces of the exhibition and admire closely these wonderful works. Now, let us come to the process of the Q's and A's to our speakers. Due to the special circumstance of the pandemic and according to the rules of hygiene, and please ask the colleagues who would like to raise a question to come close to the microphone and also state their name and the means they represent before taking the floor. Thank you. The microphone is in the middle between the customs office and the other. Is there any colleague who would like to address any question? So at this point, is there someone present? Yes, please. Thank you. Good morning. Congratulations for everything. The question I would like to raise is addressed to the Speaker of the House. My name is Spiros Kakouriotis from Monopoly GR. So the question is addressed to the Speaker of the House. It is as follows. Is it within your overall programming or perhaps in your thoughts, since one third of this building was refurbished and is brand new, whether you think of proceeding in completing the other two thirds of the refurbishment, eventually with the upgrading of the library, which unfortunately is closed to the general public for many years. Thank you. Mr. Speaker of the House, you have the floor. Thank God you raised this question, because I would then have to say something that Mr. Daskalopoulos again, Mr. Oscar Wilde has said, had given a speech in the USA, and everything was speechless from his appearance. Not from what he said, but from his appearance. And no one would ask anything. And then at the end, he said, because I have some answers, is there anyone, does anyone have a question? And thus he offered them, he gave them carriage. So the, unless you had made this question, I would have touched upon this issue. So we must clarify that this huge building is 19,500 square meters. And thanks to the intervention of the cultural organization NEON, Mr. Daskalopoulos, that is, one third, as you very appropriately said, that is 6,500 square meters, not only were renovated, they were actually refurbished and transformed into an exhibition space with all the prerequisites of such a space, which is not merely painting the walls or constructing a new flooring. We had sound interventions, mechanological interventions, hydraulics were changed, electrological interventions. NEON has spent more than 1.2 million euros for this impeccable transformation of the space into an exhibition center. And this is an inestimable capital which is integrated in the building because it is to stay here. It will be an asset of the building. Now, what will happen with the remaining building? We are currently at the stage where we study, but not in a continuous present that never ceases. We are not studying. We study and we will have a response on the overall exploitation of the building, which obviously will have as a main title its cultural dimension. And immediately after that, this whole program will claim a funding and will concern all the shell of the building. This whole study and the cultural use of such a space in the broader area coincides with the plans of the Athens municipality, which were announced by Mr. Bakoyannis, echoes what we do now and will be doing for the next 6 months. And it also echoes a parallel program for the exploitation of buildings that is currently in process by the Parliament. And I can tell you briefly that in the space of the old Parliament in Stadio Street, at the back space facing Kolokotroni and Thimougazi streets, from the Green Fund, the Green Fund will finance the refurbishment of the Benakis Library. And now we are in the stage of the contest for the contractor. And on Philelinou Street, another international competition has taken place. Another building, which is a monument owned also by the Parliament, will also be refurbished and will host other activities of the Parliament. But the flagship of all those plans is here. And this impressive onset recorded today with the NEON organization and the impressive and most generous assistance of Mr. Daskalopoulos and his cooperators, this will be pursued and will be completed. That is, the remaining parts of this building will also be refurbished on the basis of the original study, which, I tell you, this study doesn't start from scratch. It starts from the cultural character we have for this very robust landmark, this building that is currently delivered and offered to the Athenian Greek public at large. Thank you, Mr. Speaker. Any other colleague? My name is Denisa Bayraktari from propaganda.gr. I happen to be an inhabitant of the area, of this neighborhood, and what happens now, today, is unprecedented for us. On many occasions, we used to feel deserted, especially with regard to cultural events. I would like to ask you and address the question to either Mr. Daskalopoulos or Madame Kountouri. Would there be a way for this exhibition to be also include the inhabitants of the area, that is, not to wait solely for those that come away, but also have us as a part of this exhibition that live here, that go by every day and walk by the tobacco factory. Well, in my presentation, I tried to offer a guide through the exhibition, and I didn't take any time to explain the remaining of the program and how the whole area will be activated. One of our main goals is precisely to activate this area and bring in its citizens. The entry will be gratis. Any citizen having made a reservation can come and visit, stay from 2 to 4 hours and at any frequency they desire. From September onwards, we have already met with the friends and partners that work in the library and will have joined educational programs. Chrysanthi Kumnianaki, from June till the end of November, will be activating the whole of Kolonos Hill. There, they will be following on a daily basis the relation of the resident of Kolonos with the hill and will make an installation there. And we are open to your suggestions as well. There will be a program in parallel with speeches, lectures on the history of the building, discussions with the artists. And of course, the whole area is invited here. Already the day before yesterday, when Fernandez did a first setting, it was a 3-hour setting, and people, 3 or 4 families were on their balconies and followed everything. People that walk by, they ask what happens. We answer, and I hope that gradually, and following this presentation, that we will have a yeast for interest. This is an open, friendly space for coexistence and discourse. Everyone is invited. And we also have a program for schools in every exhibition where we trigger, invite, and challenge visits of children here, because this is extremely important for us here. It is proven that we didn't make any of our own plays. If someone wants to promote one's modern art, it is to build one's own space. Make a memory or something. We really wanted to be there, to be itinerary, a visit various spaces of the city. So for us, it's useful to learn how to do it better. So you who raised this question, please help us. Bring us in contact with local structures, civic society here, who are interested, so as to cooperate and have a continuous improvement. We warmly thank you, Mr. Daskalopoulos. Now, let us move to the next question. Please. Good afternoon. My name is Martina Kaltsaki from ERT. Let me ask the following. This is a wonderful space. This is an impressive exhibition. By the end of the year, we will be extremely glad and will enjoy this exhibition. I hope that many Athenians and foreigners will visit it. The question is, what happens with this wonderful space when this exhibition will be over? Who will be responsible for its operation? If there is no care for its care with people knowledgeable of the subject, that is how a cultural space operates, I really doubt its development. You also only refer to the mayor of Athens. Is it your intention to cooperate with the Athens municipality for the operation of this space? There's already Technopolis. Who will manage this space after the end of the NEON exhibition? That's the question. Is there some kind of plan? Well, this space belongs to the Hellenic Parliament. So it will still be managed by the Parliament. And we are open to suggestions that have already understood what happens. Imagine what will happen within the next 6 months. There are already suggestions for the day after. We will continue cooperating with NEON as well, because I know that they have impressive ideas for later, and we also are open to suggestions that will be submitted. It is the Parliament that we will go on handling and managing. This belongs to the Parliament, but it will not be managed insistently in an autocratic way. The proof is that any kind of exploitation and suggestion will be the result of cooperations. Therefore, we will have the liability and the responsibility, but We will pursue cooperations on cultural issues with various cultural organizations and agencies in a fertile and creative dimension, as it happens now with NEON. Allow me to add something. In this cooperation on the field with the Parliament, and this is related to this question, to who manages, we found this space, and indeed we refurbished it. But this was not empty. In this space, we cooperated with the best civil servants we have ever cooperated with, the technical department headed with Mr. Polychronopoulos, Mr. Bayraktaris, Madame Kurkuta, that accompanied us continuously and every single day. These are persons who are here, based here. They were based here long before we came here. This perhaps was an unexploited space, but it operated. And I've seen for myself how much they are fond of this space. Madame Vara, Madame Vlasopoulou, who are architects and historians of this building, keep the memory vivid with programs organized by Madame Droulia and all the schools visit. It was a space that operated. Half of the building was vivid. That's why we had this work within a year. I met people that I greatly esteem, and they are in very good hands, both in the Parliament and after the concession when NEON leaves. Thank you. The Parliament has 800 works of art, paintings, sculptures, and various other relics, historic relics, or artifacts. At this point, there is a space where all this can become known. We can present them in immediate meetings, not through publications or through internet. Therefore, that's a great field of glory. And this whole story of culture, you feel it, you know, you are journalists of the cultural events. The history of culture now really has the upper hand in opening the society, and this is extremely positive. See what happens with the old flower shops at the side of the Parliament, this space will be open again through cultural uses as well. In the refurbished flower shops, which have wind over the last years, there will also be a cultural use. The Parliament will be selling its publications, and the former fund of archaeological sites will also have a selling point for the copies, and thus will also attract new flower shops. Therefore, the Parliament views culture as a leverage for reset, both on individual and communal level. Let me add, says Mr. Daskalopoulos, that this space obviously belongs to the Parliament. This is where it will be given back. It is delivered, as we said, we deliver a work to the city that can be used. You know that NEON is not the first time that does that, that is refurbishing a space and then leaving it back to its owners. Something extremely important to us and very satisfying is that we enhance, if you like, competition and ideas from other vectors, other organizations. As the Speaker of the House said, already have suggestions. For 2022, we have already submitted a proposal to have something small for something from this space, and all the others will have the time to get organized for later. And let's see again the pigeons that were in here before we started. We warmly thank the speakers. At this point, let me convey a question sent through email by the newspaper Kathimerini. Madam Maro Vasiliadou is the journalist. She asks the following. I consider this huge interest for the use of this space following the end of this exhibition. And you mentioned all of this. Would you like to add something? The question is the following. Both the House of this House and Mr. Daskalopoulos mentioned that the refurbished old public factory, tobacco factory, will be a cultural center. Is there something more specific on the use of this space after the NEON exhibition? This is the question. I consider that you have fully elaborated on the matter already. Well, no, there's nothing more specific. As I told you, we now start seeing a congestion of intentions. There are already some proposals made by NEON that has a priority. But let us enjoy the current exhibition now. Now that we've started, nothing will stop us. There will be many interesting things to enjoy from now on. Thank you, Mr. Speaker. Is there any of the colleagues that would like to address a question? Madam Tifti, yes, please. Good afternoon. My name is Angela Tiftis from the Parliament TV station. Congratulations. The space is wonderful, as well as the exhibition. I'm a lover of modern art, and I would like to ask you if you thus offer a mark, if you open a portal to modern art in the dialogue with the current condition and with the whole world. Yes, obviously, I had the opportunity on October 14 in the Senate when there with Mr. Daskalopoulos. No, I meant December 14 of 2020. I had the opportunity to discuss with the two, with Mr. Daskalopoulos and Madam Kountouri. I had the opportunity to say that the Parliament has a tradition and a performance of extrovert character. The Parliament is the place par excellence where we have a discourse and debates and the evolutions of the country with the legislative work and legislative control, but it is also at the same time a state institution, one of the three important functions of the state. And the state, under any form, be it administration or legislating state, the state owes to contribute to the education of the citizen and the promotion of the art. This is is enshrined by the Constitution. So we contribute in promoting this art in the building per se, which is also a work of art per se, but also in other buildings belonging to the Parliament. And we make this onset from this flagship, as I said, this huge building, which presents something really innovative. Now that we start appearing full of questions about tomorrow, many of them can be addressed through modern art. The Parliament will play a role in promoting modern artists, young artists, for the Greek public to get to know them, because this is our mission, this is our duty. As you see, we do have shelters for art, as this is the case, and this is how I want everyone to view it. We thank you. Is there any other question? Is there another question? The press bureau of the Hellenic Parliament and the NEON team will be at your disposal for any additional information vis-a-vis the exhibition. And at this point, we completed the presentation of the cultural program, Modern Art 2021. The exhibition portals will be open for the public on June 11 until the end of December 2021. We warmly thank the speakers, the participants, those who are present, those who attended through the Parliament TV, and we invite you to come here so as to discover and have a tour in the wonderful works of the artists and this modern space of art of Athens. Thank you.